to be a filmmaker because I wanted to be in charge of the narrative from the moment I write it to the final cut, and not have anybody coming in telling me, oh, but that's not gonna sell, I don't understand, why the close-ups, there's no music, why just women, etc. So, you know, I didn't have to have any of these conversations throughout the entire creative process, and that was great. And also because like, this film would have never existed had I been produced. It would have been another film, and it would not have had the life it's had if it hadn't been made that way, so.
Yeah, and we were just speaking outside about, and now I'm gonna open up for questions in a few minutes, about its distribution journey, which was also interesting about taking ownership as well of the narrative around how the film gets distributed. Can you tell us a little bit about the history behind how you ended up distributing this film?
Yeah. So one of the things I knew from having been an actress, that in France, it's not the filmmaker, the director that signs with the distributor, it's a producer. So from the beginning, having funded this film on my own, I was like, by the time we get to the distribution phase, okay, first, the plan was to put it on YouTube, because like we didn't have that many ambition at the beginning. I was like, okay, let's try to finish this movie, then you know, we'll put it on YouTube. And I don't know, by the first week of editing, we're like, it is too good to be put on YouTube, we have to try and take it to theaters, you know? So then we're like, okay, how are we gonna take it to theaters? So we're like, okay, we're gonna have to find distributors. And so I was like, okay, we have to start a production company anyway, because that's the only way, if it works out, that's the only way for us to make money. Because if I sign, like if I give my rights to a producer that then signs to a distributor, I'm not gonna make any money if things work in theaters. So we had already planned on making the producing company, and because I've worked as a screenwriter, and when I was trying to just like sneak in one black character, they would tell me that it was not realistic. Once, you know, we applied for funds, and it was for a TV show where the main characters, the five main characters, were women. And in French context, they told us that it was like sort of like anti-men. Why were there no male leads, et cetera, et cetera. So I was like, when I'm gonna come with like a 24 black women cast, you know, it's not gonna be like someone's gonna be like, yeah, let's distribute this film. And I knew it was gonna be tough. And especially, and then I discovered, because I knew nothing about the industry, France is a state-funded cinema. Like independent filmmaking in France is state-funded. So there's like a lot of rules that if you're not within the cinema industry, you don't know. One of the rules I didn't know is that if you want to be able to get what's called an agreement for your investments on the film, you have to be a production company that has a capital of 45,000 euros. I started my production company with 1,000 euros because we had no money and we just like had to like, start a production company. So because we didn't have that agreement, then all the companies that would distribute the film would not be eligible for the state funds help, you know, to put the film in theaters. So that means that almost no big distribution company would take us. There were only like a few small ones who would take